allegations within the organization, that I will stand and support any officer who addresses, and I expect and demand them to address wrongdoing within the organization. They are, in fact, doing that. They do it one-on-one, face-to-face, going through internal affairs. They do it through anonymous sources. We also allow them to do that. We fully investigate all of those things. We do not hesitate from command officers down to janitors. We will investigate any facts whatsoever. And as a result, the officer that you brought to light had brought this claim forward, it started before my arrival, but as he brought it together, brought it forward, we also did our investigation starting with the highest levels of our command, going down to anybody who was addressing that. I have four officers who are focused only on that particular case, and we're going wherever that information has taken us. I've met with the officer multiple times. I've assured him from the highest point of this organization that that will not be tolerated. We will watch out for his well-being, and no one will cause him harm. I stay in regular contact with him, as does the deputy commissioner and the director of internal affairs. So we're addressing that as quickly as possible. Much like the deputy commissioner said, is that we don't care where the facts take us. We don't care where they go. Inside the organization or outside the organization, we're going to bring that to light.
One next question. I think I've heard you mention that there was going to be an independent investigation done on the West case. Is there any findings from that case?
Yes, sir. That's where Rodney Hill was sharing with you a little bit of the background. He's going to come and give you a little bit more of insight and share Rodney's schedule and share where we are today. If you have something in hand, and as we move forward.
Yes, sir. As previously stated, the board first convened January 23rd. They've convened two other times since then with members of the police department, internal affairs, and homicides answering questions. This is a completely independent board. This is volunteer, they're not being paid by the police department. They have convened numerous times since amongst themselves because they are professionals in their own right. Taking a little bit of time because they're really taking their time. They made numerous requests for documents from the police department as recent as approximately 3 weeks ago, asking for different stats and numbers, things like that. I believe that you should be getting something from them very, very soon. Last week when I asked, and I was told that they believe that they were definitely in the final stages.
Sir, I would also like to kind of state that if it was up to me to start on January 23rd, I'd like to report down in February. However, they're asking a lot of tough questions, which is what I asked them to do. They're looking very in depth. They're experts. These are not rookie people that we're bringing up. These are experts. And so I think we have to be a little patient, although I'm impatient. And I think the family needs it. I think the officer needs it. They need it. And I think the community deserves it. And so I would like to move as quickly as we possibly can. However, I also want them to do it the right way, which is what is occurring. So I have to have patience and kind of sit back as they bring it forward. But I think what comes out of there is my bottom line is what I started with them. And I said, the only thing I want you to do is tell the truth. And I think that's what they're trying to do at this point.
I'm
going to
say, I'm at the public safety meeting, as you know, at this point in the hospital, and one of the those was,
I'm sorry, I should go back around. I can't hear what you said.
I was at the public safety committee meeting that the mayor held there, but this part of the hospital, I don't know, apparently also. Yeah. And I wanted the members, I heard the mayor address one of the members in the family that she did send. And a letter to the state medical examiner office in reference to getting into asking their report. We also sent a letter also.
presentation that was made tonight, at least parts of it, the Civilian Review Board is committed as an independent agency to work cooperatively with the Baltimore City Police Department, because we believe it's in the best interest of the citizens of Baltimore to do so. However, after sitting through the presentation of the police department, the board did have concerns. The greatest concern that the board had is that it will not sign on in a perfunctory role in this review process, meaning that the history of the relationship between the Baltimore Police Department and the Civilian Review Board has not always yielded what the board believes is a serious review of what the Civilian Review Board has presented to the Baltimore Police Department, in that its recommendations are made on the findings submitted by internal investigations for internal affairs. That investigation or the finding is not always reversed in light of the decision that's been adopted by the Civilian Review Board. So there needs to be continuous discussions with the Baltimore Police Department and the Civilian Review Board, so that the Civilian Review Board has some confidence that if in fact they sign on to be a part of this process, that the recommendation is made that is different from what the findings are submitted by internal investigation or the new review board, that if those recommendations will be taken seriously.
Yes.
Representation, because one of the problems that we have is a clear and glaring
double standard in our society. If one of the citizens of this city commits a crime, there is an indictment. They are prosecuted, they are convicted, and they are thrown behind bars and charged to the fullest extent of the law. But that is not the same thing that happens with police officers who break the law in this city. So we're happy today that this hearing has been held. As I indicated earlier, some of the common denominators between Anderson, West, and King is that they are all African Americans. They are men, and they come from economically distressed populations of our city. We've got to be very cognizant of the fact that in the Anderson case specifically, we talked about integrity with police officers. We know without a shadow of a doubt, because we did community-based investigations, knocking on doors at the Baltimore City Police Department, fabricating on the police report. We know that because it was indicated on the police report that Mr. Anderson was in the process of a drug transaction. There were no illegal drugs on the scene of the crime of Mr. Anderson's murder. There was no airway obstruction in Mr. Anderson's throat. And there were no drugs on the scene of the crime. So we know full well, without a shadow of a doubt, that what the officers indicated to be the case was not the case. We know that because we talked to citizens in that particular police district who were intimidated by officers, who were told not to tell the truth as so far as this incident was concerned. And I'm not somebody who's separate or set apart because I've seen the bodies of two people laying up on slabs who were killed by the Baltimore City Police. Okay? So having stated that, when we look at the issue of George King, and I've helped too many mothers who've lost their sons to the police as well. George King's mother is not able to be here today because she lives in another part of the state, and it's financially costly for her to be able to be here today. But she lost her only son to the Baltimore City Police Department. What we do know is that Mr. King, through our own investigation, was also special needs. What we talked about for a long time here is that we need a specialized police unit in Baltimore City that has the skills and the qualifications to deal with our special needs and our mental health population. We've been talking about that, asking for that, demanding that, for as long as we can remember. Many of you remember that about 2 years ago, myself and a colleague were arrested here at City Hall. This was prior to the murder of Tyrone West. This was prior to the murder of Mr. King. And we just believe that had the city of Baltimore taken this issue seriously then, maybe West would still be alive today. Maybe Mr. King would still be alive today. When we look at the issue of Taser International, Taser manufacturers indicates that any more than one taser has the potential to be dead.
Yes.
Mr. King was tased 5 times by a taser. So we know that the potential to become deadly became a reality, thus resulting in a 19-year-old, otherwise healthy young man going into cardiac arrest and having a heart attack on the scene of the crime.
Tased my nephew 3 times and then tased him.
When we look at the Civilian Review Board in Baltimore City, I'm glad that Mr. Gilyard was here, and I'm glad he spoke about the issue within the Civilian Review Board. One of the problems we had, I personally took a citizen to the Civilian Review Board and worked with them to file a complaint, and nothing ever came of that complaint with the Civilian Review Board. Now, as so far as excessive and deadly force, to us as citizens, we could care less. I put my son here 5 years old. That's what we're concerned about. We want justice for our communities. And so if the Civilian Review Board is not looking at deadly cases, we hope that you all, after taking the leadership to hold this hearing, that we look at a body that can look at both excessive and deadly force cases. Not to mention the fact there are Civilian Review Boards around this country who are allotting settlements. You know, there are attorneys who are in this room today. There are multi-million-dollar lawsuits that have been filed against the police department for deadly force and for killing black men in Baltimore City. The reason why I'm happy that you're holding this hearing is because the city of Baltimore will be bankrupt by these type of cases. Because we encourage people to sue the hell out of the police department for killing their loved ones and for breaking up families. And I know that for some people this is just an issue, but when you hug a family member who's lost a family member to the police, when you have family members who are here today who've lost their loved ones to the police, for them this is not just an issue. And that is why we had 6% turnout yesterday at the polls. And we talked to people, the one race that they were certain about
was to race for Baltimore City State's attorney, and I could have to say this too, that if the race for police commissioner were up yesterday, I'm quite certain they'd be talking about that.
Thank you.